Good morning, everybody, and a happy Wednesday morning. Once again, this video is so long, I'm having to split it into two. So this is part one. There is a part two. Now, the funny thing is we only have like one main topic. I think you all know what it's going to be, but there's one main topic. There's one reminder. There's one new topic, and then there's some interesting stuff at the end. So let's just jump in and get there, shall we? Let's go. I'm going to start off once again by reminding you all that I have a Patreon. YouTube has already taken me down once before. Just in case something should happen, you know where to find me. I have two tiers, $1 and $3. It's less than a fancy cup of coffee per month, okay? You can find the link in the description box. Here it is, the one story I have before we jump into the one big story that I'm covering today. Apparently, George Michael limited edition coins have just been unveiled by the Royal Mint. So as of February 26th, Wham fans can now own an official Charles-approved coin dedicated to the late George Michael. Apparently, you can't buy anything with the coins. There's special coins for collection, but they're not going to be in circulation per se. There are three versions of the coin that you can choose from. Each one, it's being reported, is a portrait wearing his, you know, aviator sunglasses, the cross earring, and an engraving from the refrain from Faith. Oh, all right, moving on. All right, I also have an update. I lied. I have an update. We know that Harry has had his U.S. visa called into court. We know that the people for the Department of Homeland Security actually showed up with nothing and basically said, just because Harry said in the book he used drugs doesn't make it true. So let's just look at a few times Harry's opened his gob, shall we?
There's a fair amount of drugs, marijuana, magic mushrooms, cocaine. I mean, that's going to surprise people.
But important to acknowledge. To distract myself from how whatever I was thinking, and I would, you know, resort to drugs as well.
And again, divulges his fondness for drugs. I started doing it recreationally, he says, and I started to realise how good it was for me. He's talking about psychedelic narcotics. I would say it's one of the more fundamental parts of my life that changed me and helped me deal with the traumas and pains of the past. Well, there's been an advert not taking drugs. It's old Harry, isn't it?
28 to probably 32 was a nightmare time in my life. I was willing to drink, I was willing to take drugs.
Little late now to be claiming it was a lie. Now, also people are talking about the fact that Harry ran to the UK, sat with his dad for 15 minutes and came home. But he must have known what was going to happen. He was seen in Canada with Meghan, surrounded by cameras. Everybody noted that during the 3 days he and Meghan were there, nobody talked about Invictus. It was all about him and Meghan. He wasn't wearing Invictus gear and there were cameras everywhere. Now we know why. Out of the blue, without warning, Prince Harry's documentary about Invictus dropped on Hulu. Now you have to know that right off the bat, somebody reached out to Netflix to ask them about them, and their comment was that they were surprised to hear it. That makes you wonder if their deal is dead, because remember, they have a 5-year deal with Netflix that started in 2020, but we also know that The Heart of Invictus on Netflix did not do well at all. So this is called Good Morning America, and he's talking to the host, Will Reeve. To start with, they talk about Invictus. Once again, they put out misinformation saying he's the only founder, which we know now is not true. They bring up the Queen and they even show interviews with the Obamas from 2016. And there's a lot more of Meghan in this than what we saw before. But basically, this is a mishmash of the other interview that we already saw. Now, Jobson, who is an reporter and who kind of likes to flip-flop back and forth, said that he thought William was jealous of how much money and how well Invictus is doing. Yeah, I don't think so.
A big thank you to this Twitter user for pointing out that the Royal Foundation accounts show that £550,000 was transferred from the Endeavor Fund to Invictus because Harry left with no funds. And let's not forget that in 2020, a $1 million donation was given. This is a different amount because 550,000 pounds doesn't add up to a million. This is a different donation. So when Harry and Meghan were screaming about the royals were neglecting Invictus, this was given. It's just amazing. It was $1.11 million to the charity. Yep. This took place after Harry and Meghan had left for the United States and after the Oprah interview. I can't believe that either, but it's true. For some reason, everybody wants to forget that the Invictus was set up by Prince William, Princess Catherine, and Prince Harry, along with the Royal Foundation. This was not just done by Prince Harry. Now, William agreed to step back. Everybody stepped back. They let Harry run with it. And then they wanted to, you know, put out comments like this, that William is jealous. In everybody's dreams, he's jealous. He's going to be the next king. Mr. Jobson also said that the royal family doesn't talk about the Invictus Games anymore. Well, it's Harry's. Why would they? Now, you should note that he is a friend of Omid Scobie's, as you can see. And apparently, it's being reported that right now he's writing a book about William. I have to be honest. I think he just killed his career. Any book that he would write about William after the nasty comments he put in this is nothing that I would read. He also said that there's absolutely no relation between the king and Harry and Meghan's children, and basically said that that's the king's fault. The king should have made more effort. I'm not kidding. The first few minutes were about Invictus, but mostly about Harry and how Harry felt about Invictus, about Harry doing things for Invictus. They brought Meghan up again, like she did in the Netflix docuseries, saying, "I wasn't thrown to the woods, I was fed to the wolves." It was inevitable that Harry then sat down and was talking about William, and, you know, he threw William under the bus. I find it also interesting that when they talked about Harry and Meghan's children, they referred to them as Princess Lilibet and Prince Archie. But when they talked about William and Catherine's children, it was their George, Charlotte, and Louis. This was just a rehash of the Netflix docuseries. He accused William of making up stories. William's office attacked him. And the media is responsible because the media pitched him against William, the heir with the spare, and Catherine against Meghan. But you know, that's not true, because you could write anything you want in the media, but if you're not watching it, you're not paying attention to it, then it doesn't usually affect your personal life. So what Harry is feeding, I'm just not eating. And in talking about the media, of course, they mentioned Harry's win with his legal case. He's going to get them. He's going to make them stop putting out misinformation. At the same time, they forgot to mention that Harry withdrew a different case that now puts him 750,000 pounds in the hole. Interesting the way the media is spinning this. And that is misinformation. That is a lie by omission. Now, Harry did say some interesting things like, "What people don't understand are the lengths I've gone through to resolve this privately." Now, here comes the damage control. Harry took unintentional swipes at William and the king. There was nothing unintentional about what he said. They're saying this is not a PR stunt by Harry to include a jealous swipe at William and how Charles doesn't have a relationship with the kids. And the interviews are from across many years. And at some point, Harry's relationships with his family, you know, have been low, and he probably said things that he thought better of afterwards, and, you know, etc., etc. Are you telling me that this was put together without his approval? And yes, he's been attacking the family for 4 years. So of course there's going to be horrible things about the family. They're saying that this is not new news, and they just use these things to hook you in, because on the whole, it's a positive documentary. I'm sorry, I beg to differ. This is a documentary about Harry and his crappy relationship with his family. It's supposed to be about Invictus, and once again, nothing really about Invictus. That's my opinion. The question is, why would Harry and Meghan risk their contract? Let's take a look at their finances really, really quickly. Although we heard that their deal might be worth $100 million, apparently they only got paid for stuff that they produced. The total amount of money it's being reported given to them by Netflix is $22.9 million for their 6-part docuseries, Harry and Meghan, which we know was just an exercise in self-pity. That's not even close to the $100 million that we all heard about, okay? Then we heard heard about the memoir Spare, where Harry was paid $20 million advance. However, we also know that it is a financial fail for Penguin Random House. So we don't know that they're ever going to give him a chance to do another book. They're calling it a one and done. All right, you guys, this is the end of part one. Remember, there's two parts. So you're going to finish this video. You're going to put your comments down, right, on what you've seen so far. Then you're going to go on over to part two because you do not want to miss this. Trust me. All right, let's keep going. Let's head on over to part two.